This class we discuss about carbon arc welding, CAW. Carbon arc welding is a process which produces coalescence of metal by heating them with an arc between a non-consumable carbon, that is graphite electrode, and the workpiece. This is a setup. This is a power source. This is an electrode holder. This is a carbon electrode. This is a welding rod. This is a workpiece. Here, positive terminal is connected to the workpiece. Negative terminal is connected to the carbon electrode. This is a tin carbon arc welding process. Here we are using two carbon electrodes. Again, this is positive. This positive terminal is connected to the workpiece. Negative terminals are connected to the carbon electrodes. This is a filler metal. Carbon arc welding is one of the oldest welding techniques that are still in use today. DC power supply is used in this welding process. It is essential that the welding circuit is set up for straight polarity. If reverse polarity setting is used, the arc will not be stable and a carbon residue will be left to become entrapped in the weld. Working principle of carbon arc welding is, in carbon arc welding, the intense heat of an electric arc developed between a carbon electrode and workpiece metal is used for welding. The carbon electrode is connected to negative terminal and the workpiece is connected to the positive terminal. Because positive terminal is hotter, that is 4000 degrees centigrade, than the negative terminal, that is 3000 degrees centigrade, when an arc is produced, low voltage and high current is used to heat the metal. Once an arc is formed between a carbon electrode and the workpiece being welded, if an arc is formed between two electrodes, the technique is known as thin carbon arc welding process. Now we'll see the process of carbon arc welding. In this method, an arc is produced between carbon electrode and workpiece. A rod of carbon is used as negative pole and the work being welded as positive pole. The carbon electrode does not melt itself. It is a non-consumable electrode. The electrodes that are used in carbon arc welding consisting of baked carbon or pure graphite, which was placed inside a copper jacket. During the welding process, the electrode is not consumed as the weld progresses over time. However, the electrode will need to be replaced due to erosion. A filler rod is used separately at the welding joint. The arc is established between the workpiece and the carbon electrode, held in the electrode holder. A long carbon arc is often desirable in order to prevent contamination of the weld metal with the carbon monoxide given off by the carbon electrode under the energy of the arc. In the carbon arc welding of light cage plates, the use of filler rod may not be necessary. But in welding of heavy plates of filler rod consisting of the same material as the base metal is generally used. The filler rod is then inserted in the weld pool, the arc being directed against it, just above the surface of the molten metal. The end of the rod is thus melted off and deposited in the weld pool. The arc is played to and fro in the weld pool, thoroughly melting and mixing the metal. No filler rod is necessary to make a lap weld on light cage metal with a carbon electrode. The amount of fusion will depend upon the speed with which the arc is moved over the surface. For less fusion, the current should be increased and the electrode advanced at a faster rate. This is the process of carbon arc welding. Advantages of carbon arc welding. Number 1, low cost of equipment and the welding operation. Number 2, skilled labor is not required. Number 3, this process can be easily automated. Number 4, low distortion of the workpiece. Disadvantages of carbon arc welding are, number 1, unstable quality of weld produces porosity. Porosity is a weld defect. Number 2, carbon of electrode contaminates weld material with the carbides. Number 3, this welding process produces bright light, which is dangerous for welders if they are not wearing the proper eye protection and clothing. Applications of carbon arc welding are, this welding process is used for welding both ferrous and non-ferrous metals like steel sheet, brass, bronze, gunmetal, MS sheet and carbon steel. With this, I conclude my lecture. Thanks for listening.